Good morning, it's James. It's very good to see you this morning. It's always so good to see you. And this morning, I just want to let you know how much I love and appreciate you. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your energy. I'm deeply grateful to have the honor and the blessing of laying eyes on you. And I do hope and pray that this message finds you and all the people that you love peaceful, thriving, and very, very well. So this morning, I woke up under the influence of a very heavy heart. And like you, I am not afraid of a heavy heart. I'm well aware when my heart is heavy, and I don't do myself the disservice or the injustice of distracting myself and putting on a face and pretending everything is okay. Everything is not okay. And I do everything I can, like you do, to continually love with resolve, continually show up with my heart open wide, and do everything that I can do to, in spite of what's happening across the world, be a beneficial presence on the planet, not dim my light because of what the world is casting in such a dark way. So this morning, I would love for all of us to remember that you're not alone. Remember that all of us here in this community are heroic in the way that we show up each and every day. And if we're feeling like we're having a hard time showing up, just know this is a safe place to come as you are. If your heart is heavy, like I believe everyone in this community, when you look around the world, you see what's happening in the world, it's all too understandable to feel like, what do I do? How do I do this? How do I not look, but how do I not look away? I know I need to understand what's happening to the degree that I can, and then I need to have a spiritual response, which is, for me these days, not necessarily needing to watch the news, but being aware of what's happening. I want to be aware, and then I want to ask myself, what's mine to do? I think all of us right now would love to know that we have something beautiful to do. And that beautiful thing is to be courageous in how we love. And how we love in times like these, to me, is simply be carrying prayer. As much as you can remember, all day, every moment, carrying a prayer for peace, carrying a prayer for healing, carrying a prayer for compassion, for openness, for us waking up and allowing ourselves to be fully open to living up to what I believe peace needs to see right now. There is a time that we are in right now, and that time is not about judging. This time is not about adding to oppression. It's not about adding to anything that further distances ourselves, one another, or anything from what we are being asked to do right now. I think all of us who are not necessarily in the conflict, but are part of the conflict. We may not be in Israel. We may not be in the Gaza Strip. We may not be in the West Bank. We may not be Israelis. We may not be Palestinians. We may not be Gazans. But we are all humans, all of us. And the ones who are not there need to be here. We need to be here in prayer. We need to be here in love. We need to be here holding light. We need to be holding a prayer that we will find our way through. And maybe if we can envelop that whole area in the world with a level of love, with a level of openness, with a level of courage, with a level of compassion, and a heroic level of understanding that we can heal, that they can heal, and understanding that the we and the they can becoming us. All of us need to heal. And this is a perfect time for us to be demonstrations of that healing. Let us be conscious of the way we carry ourselves today. Let us be conscientious of the way we look at one another today. People that we love, people that we'd say, that's a stranger, I don't know them, but know them. Know that all of us are feeling a heaviness because the currency that is passing around the planet right now is heavy and hard. So we need to carry an energy that's light and loving. And maybe, just maybe, the healing comes through us, in us, and as us. And something greater than what's happening, so much greater than what's happening, allows us to see love in action in a way that we've never seen before. All the different places across the world that are struggling, all the innocent people that are going through hell. Let us hold heaven for them, because we get a chance in this moment to remember who we are and what we're all here to do. Common humanity, living up to the expression, the demonstration of heroic love. Hero means to protect. That is the etymology of hero. And we need to protect everyone, all, and bring us into a place, a beautiful place of peace. Thank you for being open. Thank you for answering your heart's calling and answering the knowing that our soul always has and always has known, and asking us to remember. I love you.